Hello, this is James Pickles, Phast and Safety product owner. In this video, I'm going to explain how to define the grid size and resolution for the 3D viewer in Phast. Within this study here, I have a model that has been set up to produce results in three dimensions. Please check out our separate video titled How to View Dispersion and Radiation Results in 3D for instructions on this. So, to define an appropriate grid size, you go to the parameters tab, and here we have the 3D viewer parameters. And within this 3D viewer parameters, you're able to define the grid size and resolution for the 3D viewer. Before you set those parameters, it's recommended to view the results in the two-dimensional graphs. So here we're going to look at dispersion results. And if we take a look at the side view plot, then we should use this plot to provide us with some guidance on the appropriate 3D viewer parameters. So if I open up the 3D viewer parameters alongside this 2D graph, on the dispersion cloud tab, what you have is grid size and resolution in the x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. And within each of those, you're able to define the starting coordinate of the 3D grid, the step size, and the number of steps. So if we take a look at this side view plot, we can use this to help us decide on the appropriate resolution in the z direction. Now, we can start the calculations, the 3D calculations, at 0 meters. So our starting Z coordinate can be at 0 meters. Now let's say that, for example, we'd put in a step size of 15 meters and we had 3 steps. Now what would happen here is that the 3D calculations would be performed at 0 meters, which is the starting coordinate, and then they would next be performed at 15 meters, because the step size is 15 meters. And then the next one after that would be up at 30 meters. Now, because this cloud is actually confined between 15 meters and the next step size of 30 meters, then when we view the 3D results, we won't actually see any results because the resolution isn't fine enough to capture this particular cloud. So if I run this model just to demonstrate that, now the calculation speed here really depends on your grid resolution. The resolution that I had here was relatively coarse, so this particular model only took 5 seconds, but if you have a very fine grid, some of these models can take up to a few minutes to run. So if we have a look at the 3D results for this now, you'll see that there's no cloud displayed. And that's because the resolution isn't fine enough in the Z direction to capture the cloud. So if we go back to the graph, we look at the 3D viewer parameters again. We go to the Z direction, and then let's say that we want to define a resolution of a step size of 2 meters, and then we want to go all the way up to, let's say, 30 meters just to capture the whole cloud. So we have number of steps, 15 steps. So we would have the total grid size would go all the way up to 30 meters, which is 2 meters multiplied by 15 steps. So if we click OK on that, and then we run this model, this will take a bit longer to run now. I think it takes around 15 seconds to run, and that's because we have a much finer grid resolution in the Z direction. Okay, now once that's run, we can view the results in three dimensions, and you can see now we can see this dispersion cloud in three dimensions. That's because the resolution is fine enough to capture the cloud. It's also the same for the X directions and the Y directions. So for this, we can look at the footprint graph. And then if we go to the 3D viewer parameters, view those alongside, the X direction is along the center line of the cloud, and the Y direction is perpendicular to the center line. So here, the Y axis definition has been set up for it to start at minus 10 meters. We could have started it at minus 5 meters, say, but I've just started it at minus 10 meters. And then the step size is 1 meter. So the 3D calculations will be performed every meter in the Y direction. And then the number of steps is 20. So we have 20 meters worth of steps, which is 1 meter multiplied by 20 steps. It starts at minus 10 meters. So from minus 10 meters, the calculations will be performed 20 meters from minus 10 meters. So it will go all the way from minus 10 meters all the way up to plus 10 meters, 20 meters worth of steps. If we'd set up a step size of, say 20 meters, and we started at minus 10 meters, then the next step size after minus 10 would be at plus 10, and it would miss the cloud, which again would mean that we don't see anything in the 3D viewer. So the recommendation is to view the results in the 2D graphs in order to give you some guidance on defining the appropriate parameters for the grid size and the resolution. Thank you for listening, and if you have any questions or would like to get in touch, please email digital@dnvgl.com.